Again, it's Amanda Bullion. I was gonna let y'all, with the holiday seasons coming up, I was gonna go ahead and do a couple of recipes. I've got a recipe for meatballs here, and I'm gonna show you that right fast. Right here is that recipe. If you want to screenshot that. And I am starting off with, and I've already got the top of it off right there, with, I'm going to chop this onion right here. And I usually go to Walmart and get the ones that's pre-sliced and chopped. That way I don't have to deal with it. But when I went to Walmart, they didn't have any already done. So I'm going to go ahead and chop this up, and I won't worry about showing y'all the rest. Okay, I will let you see a little bit. I already cut this into sections. It's already getting to me. I already cut these into slices. I don't know if you can tell. So I'm going to put that in down. This is usually how small I usually cut it. I usually put that down and just slice it like that. So I get two of them at one time. Don't waste time. And get it all done faster. And boy, these are getting to me. I don't know if you can tell. My eyes are watering. Okay, I've got all of my ingredients together. I'm going to start by putting my hamburger, 1 pound of hamburger meat out. And I've got gloves because I don't want to be playing in hamburger meat without gloves on. Sorry, but I do not like touching hamburger meat without gloves on. I can always take the gloves off and not have the hamburger stuck up all in my nails and have to try to get it out from under my nails. Okay. Plus, after this, I can take off the gloves and kind of touch everything else and put the gloves back on and not have everything else contaminated. That is my 1 pound of hamburger meat. I'll set that on the side. I'll just waste the glove. You'll be alright. Take that off like that. Take it off where it's inside out. Throw that away. Alright, I've got my 1/4 of a thing of onion. Throw that in there. Alright, 1/4 of a teaspoon. Okay, I've got my 1/4 of a teaspoon. And I'm going to go ahead and get my pepper out. I'm going to use my little lip right here to just break that off. And if you didn't see what I've done, I'm going to do that again. I'm going to just pull that right there and then rake off of that little lip right here.
just the level off my spoon.
Alright. I'm sure y'all know how to do that, but tell you how to do it and then people know how to do it. Alright. Teaspoon of salt, which I do not have a fourth. I'll just use this. I'll just do it four times instead of the three. I can't do my little trick on this one, so I'll just level it off. There's one, two, three, and one more. And I'm using the sea salt because I like sea salt better. There's four. Because it's raw eggs, I'm doing the same thing with the gloves. Because I really don't like touching raw stuff and then touching everything else. But I'm going to go ahead and do my water right fast. So, balance of stuff. There's one tablespoon and two tablespoons of water. One cracked egg. Alright, and usually with this, I just dig in my hands and just mush everything up, which is why I put on the gloves. And I'm going to waste another pair of gloves on this one too, because I'm going to have to take and get my glass pan out. Egg on it, so I can't use it. And it looks kind of odd right now, but it's gonna be good when I put it into the microwave. All right, and yes, I put it in the microwave. How I cook it. I don't put it in the oven. I cook it in the microwave. That's how I was taught to cook this one. Okay. Alright. And yes, I've got some more onion right here, but that's going to go in. I've got this ready. I'm going to go ahead and start picking this out. I do not grease my pan. Alright, I do the meatballs about that size. And I'll show you the rest in a bit. I've got my plate of meatballs. I'm going to take this paper towel and wrap it over top so it doesn't splatter all over top of my microwave, and it will. And now I'm going to take it over to my microwave. Set you to where you can see me. And I'm going to put it on. Put it on 5 minutes.
fan of margarine.
Okay. Alright. With this, I need a tablespoon of butter. So I've got a, I'll set you down for a minute. I've got a thing of butter right here. I'm gonna cut it into a tablespoon. Here, make sure all my paper's off, and it is. Take this and rake off my onions in there. Now, what I like to do is go ahead and cook this a little bit so it cooks up the onions partially. And I like to take what I have left and put it over my butter so it saves my butter.
Meatballs. So they are done. Okay.
So they are finished. Now, usually, when I have a big batch, I will sometimes have to take and move the inside outside and then put it in for another little bit because the inside sometimes is not all the way done because they're a little thick or they don't get all the way done. So sometimes you have to do that. Just make sure they are completely finished because you do not want to get sick off of meat and you do not want anybody else getting sick off of meat because you didn't do what you were supposed to. So sometimes I will go ahead and do that and just switch it and put the rawer ones on the outside and put it in for another minute and it'll cook all the rest of the way. That down. Trying to find a spot to put it. Put that right here. Alright. Well, this is a cooking. I'm going to take in. I usually put my brown. Alright, so, and it says packed. So it needs to be, make sure that it is pressed into the spoon. Nice and pressed. So that is nice and packed. I'm going to set that one down, and I've got this little table, half a tablespoon, nice and packed. Put this back up, now here my onions are done. Now, on your onions. You want them to cook until they are nice and almost translucent. Put on all of this. This recipe really is more like a recipe for blind people. So really I would triple. I usually do 5 pounds.
for me, for like a big family thing. But that's just me. I like extremes. But like I said, that's just me. I like to have enough for everybody. That way, nobody goes hungry. Tablespoon of soy sauce. Okay. Doing my, let's see. Which is my favorite. I like the pecan one. That is the best sauce. Not to get the big things of fat in there with them. Well, the fat's not that bad. I just better not have big old blobs of it in there. This is what it is.
me put this away. This is what it's going to look like after you get done. And I'm going to make myself a sandwich, and I will use it as my thumbnail. And I hope y'all enjoy. And my next video, I am going to do sweet potato casserole. And I hope to have that up before too long. And leave me a like if you like this. And leave me a comment if you tell me if you've tried this or not. Tell me what you think. Y'all have a good day. Bye.